In most circumstances, I can use Creality Print to slice a file, and it's usually a non-issue, a non-event. It just goes. So like, here is an example. So this is an STL of a twin GoTech mount, right? And then if you decide you want to slice it, it'll tell you you need to add support. So you add support and you slice. Bada bing, bada boom, ain't nothing to it, right? And the same is true on the Windows PC, on the Skylake. But I came across one the other day as I was doing a Serenity Prayer plaque for my wife's office. And this has a lot of upraised lettering on it and everything. And the Mac Pro really struggled. And I began to doubt whether the Mac Pro was going to work out for my purposes. So I ran it on the Windows machine, and the Windows machine took a long time too. Then it occurred to me, what if I was to pit both of these machines, the Mac Pro versus the Hackintosh, Mac Pro sporting 2 6-core Xeon processors for a grand total of 12 cores, 24 threads, and 32 gigabytes of RAM versus the Hackintosh with an i7 Skylake, 4 cores, 8 threads, 32 gigabytes of RAM. The Hackintosh has the advantage of a higher clock speed. The Mac has the advantage of more cores. Which would be faster? The files are set up, support's been added, we're ready to slice. Go! Mac Pro takes an early lead, but the Skylake fights back. Running within 2%. The Mac inches ahead. The Skylake catches up. This is a close battle. Videographer failed to properly frame the scene. Measure the progress in relation to the blue box under the progress bar. The Skylake could be inching ahead. Oh, out of nowhere, the Mac springs forth, unleashing its 24 threads to pummel the Skylake. What an epic battle.